Now we just looked at proportions, and now I want to take a look at odds ratio. Odds ratios, I think, are very nice, very, very nice technique. Sometimes the meaning of the odds ratio is much more intuitive than that of simply a proportion. Now, here's the idea of an odds ratio. You start off by creating this 2x2 table. By the way, this is the exact same scenario that we just looked at with the proportions. Now, this is a 2x2 table because the data has two rows and two columns. This is row one, row two. This is column one, column two. So, how many males were in favor? Well, there are 192 men. How many women? There were 214 women. How many were not in favor? Well, if 192 of 273 were in favor, then 273 minus 192 were not in favor, and that was the 81. So for the females, this would be 291 minus 214, which will give me 77. Now we need to introduce just a little bit of notation. And I'm going to just clean this up a little bit. I'm just simply going to get rid of this and make it simply 81 now that you know where it came from. And I'm going to get rid of this and simply make it 77 now that you know where it came from. Now, notation wise, we refer to 192 as being N, fix that color, N11. 81 would be N12. This would be N21 and N22. Now, these notations, this N, I'm going to say IJ. This is the row number and this is the column number. So N11 refers to the number in row 1, column 1. N21 is row 2, column 1, and so forth. This notation will be important when we start playing around in TC Stats. And it'll help for the general explanation for the odds ratio. Now, in general, an odds of something happen is the probability that it will happen divided by the probability it will not happen. So that's in favor versus not in favor. So the probability for the males of happening being in favor would be 192 divided by not 81, but this is probabilities. So it's 192 divided by 273. That's the probability it will happen. Divided by the probability it will not happen, that is going to be 81 divided by 273. Obviously, the 273s will cancel, and I end up with 192 over 81. That's the odds for the males. The odds for the females will be 214 over 291 divided by 77 over 291. Again, the 291s cancel, and I get 214 over 77. So this is one odds, this is the second odds. And if you notice, this has the form of N11 divided by N12. This has the form N21 divided by N22. So if I take the ratio of both of these odds, I get this ratio. And algebraically, what's kind of nice about that, let me erase some of this, get a little bit more room, is this is the same as N11 times N22 divided by N12 times N21. Well, if I look at this, that is just cross multiplication off the table. I went through all that simply to show you that once you have the table, the numerator is simply this multiplied together, the denominator is simply these guys multiplied together. This is the ratio, the odds ratio of men to women. Obviously, if I turn it around, then it would be women to men. So when I actually calculate that, and I'm going to let TC Stats do that, when I actually calculate it, I can make a determination as a difference of odds. Now, notation-wise, we use lambda equals the population odds ratio. Now, up until now, all the sample statistics have been letters out of our alphabet. This is the first time we're going to use a Greek letter for a sample statistic. We're going to take that Greek letter lambda and put a hat over it, lambda hat. That's going to equal the sample odds ratio. This is lambda hat. Now for a hypothesis test, we would say the null hypothesis is lambda, the true odds ratio, equals 1. If the odds are the same, then they equal 1, because it's a ratio of two numbers. If they're different, then the alternative hypothesis would say that lambda is, and it depends on which way you have them. You could have greater than, you could have less than, or you may be equal to, or maybe interested in not equal to 1. You'd have to choose one of these based on the scenario. Now, based on our scenario, we're looking for evidence that more women were in favor. And I did this as males over females. So since it's male over females, and if we're expecting more females, then what we would expect is less than 1, because we expect the denominator to be bigger. So let's go ahead and actually complete the hypothesis test in TC Stats, and then we better interpret the results, and hopefully I can then convey to you how personally I think that the odds ratio are so much nicer and why. Right now it might seem like a bunch of mumble jumbo, but in a moment, hopefully, it's going to pop out at you. Okay, so back in TC Stats, this is the hypothesis test from the proportions. Now I'm going to simply select odds ratio. And here's row 1, row 2, column 1, column 2, N11, N12, and so forth. So I need to put those values in. This was 192 and 81. This one was 214 and 77. And I will, if I need a confidence interval, yeah, I'm going to do one. I'm going to stick a confidence interval in there, 0.95, just to make a point to you. And I'm going to update. I have the odds ratio of 0.8529 with a huge p-value, 0.8018. So in other words, this is, you would fail to reject, so you'd say that there's not any evidence. Now, let's take a look at this for a second. Lambda hat was 0.8529. The p-value, oops, I made a mistake, I just see. I just spotted that. I had this set up wrong. This equals, and this should be less than 1. That makes much more sense. Update it, and there we go. The p-value was 0.1982, and my 95% confidence interval was 0.5904. to 1.2320. Now, this is what this odds ratio is saying. So stay with me for a second, because it's the interpretation of the odds ratio that makes it so strong. This is saying for every 0.8529 men in favor, there is 1 woman in favor. This is 0.8529 to 1 men to women. Now, if I wanted to make this women to men, all I have to do is go back to TC Stats and change the order. Now there's not a switch order, so I actually have to type them in. So this is going to be 192, and this is 81, this was 77, and 214. Now it's set up so that women are in the rows and men's in the columns. And now when I hit update, see my sample odds is 1.1725. And obviously I need to switch this because I think the women's greater. Update it again. There's my same p-value, 0.1982. So my new sample odds ratio is 1.1725. So now I have lambda hat as being 1.1725. This is still 1.1725 to 1, but this is now women to men. And sometimes this order is much easier for people to understand. So this is the same for every 1.1725 women in favor. There's only one man. And if you were to actually take this odds ratio, 0.8529, and take 0.8529 and raise it to the negative 1, that's the same as 1 over 0.8529, within rounding, you will get 1.1725. That's the effect of simply changing the order of the rows. Now this, I think, is extremely powerful, especially when you have something, suppose you have a medical situation where you have survive to not survive, and it's like 3.62 to 1. This is saying for every 3.62 people that survive with this new drug, only one survives without the new drug. And that type of approach, I think, is extremely powerful. Now, let's go back to this confidence interval. This confidence interval, 0.59 to 1.2. And if I look at this on the number line, see this room here, and 1 is right there, 0.5904 would be like right here, and 1.2320 would be right here. See, 1 is in the interval. Well, if one is in the interval, then they could be the same. Hence, a failure to reject makes a lot of sense. On the other hand, we're in pretend land here for a moment. Suppose this interval was, say, 2.751 to 4.31. Well, now, let me erase this. Whoops. There we go. Well, now I'm up here at 2.7 out to 4 point something, and you see that 1 is not in their interval, so we're saying that it looks like there is a difference, that men or women, whoever was first, actually has a higher odds. So that's what it means to be bounded above 1. Likewise, similar strength would be if it's bounded below. If I had something like 0.2 to 0.4, this would also indicate statistical significance because, once again, 1 is not in the interval. Now, in terms of the interpretation, just one more quick thing. I want to go way back up to here. There are several ways you can interpret it off of the table, but what I would key on, and I instruct my students to key on, is this column right here, the in favor and males. So whatever odds ratio I get, and this number is not what's important, it's just this column here because it's both in favor and males. So this will be the odds of males in favor to females in favor. So if this odd turns out to be, I'm going to make up a number, 2.4, say 2.41, this is 2.41 to 1, and this would be males in favor to females in favor. If you wanted it not in favor, then what I suggested you simply change the table so that the 81 and the 77 were here, 192 and 214 were here. Then you'd have it as a not in favor. So set the table up in a way that makes sense to you to interpret, to say in English. Here it's males in favor to females in favor.